This is the today's our topic from class 12 is today we are going to study development of female gametophyte, and female gametophyte is known as embryo sac. Okay, the topic of today is female gametophyte and the development of embryo. So as we know, this is an anatropous ovule. This opening side is known as micropylar end, and this side is known as chalazal end. This type of ovule is known as anatropous ovule. Okay, these are the cells which are known as nucellous mass. One of the cell of the nucellous mass towards micropylar end will grow in size and will convert into MMC. MMC means megaspore mother cell. Remember this, one of the cell of nucellus towards the micropylar end will convert into MMC, megaspore mother cell. Okay, now we study how the embryo sac develops. This megaspore mother cell is a diploid cell. Whenever we are mentioning the cell, we have to mention that this is micropylar end and this is chalazal end. In megaspore mother cell which is a diploid cell, one meiotic division will take place, and in one meiotic division four cells will arrange themselves in linear manner. So this is known as, these are four cells, so these are known as tetrad. These are megaspore tetrad, and all are haploid cell. One meiotic division resulted into four cells, and four cells are arranged in linear manner. Okay, now the three cells which are towards chalazal end will degenerate. And one cell towards micropylar end will survive. So this is the cell which is going to survive, and these 1, 2, 3 cell will destroy, they will degenerate. Okay, now the surviving cell towards micropylar end will grow in size. This is the survival megaspore. Now in this survival megaspore, karyokinesis will take place. One karyokinesis results into two nucleus, two karyokinesis result in four nucleus, three karyokinesis results in eight nucleus. So three karyokinesis means nucleus will divide. Three karyokinesis means we will get eight nucleus. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now these eight nucleus will arrange themselves in such a manner that three will go towards chalazal end, three will go towards micropylar end, and two will come in center. Three will go towards chalazal end, three will come towards micropylar end, and two will come in center. Okay, now these nucleus, cytokinesis will take place. What will happen in cytokinesis? Cytokinesis will take place only in upper cells, and the cells are towards micropylar end, and a wall will form around these nucleus. So this is one wall, that means one cell, this is second cell, and this is third cell, 4, 5, 6. Okay, once again I am making you revise. After 8 nucleus, cytokinesis will take place. Cytokinesis means the wall will be formed around the nucleus which are towards the chalazal end and towards the micropylar end. Now this is the structure. This is the structure of embryo sac. This is the structure of embryo sac. Upper three cells will be known as antipodal cells. These two small cells will be known as synergic. One bigger cell will be known as egg cell, and two center nuclei will be known as polar nuclei. This entire structure is known as embryo sac, and this is eight nucleated and seven celled structure. We can confirm it. There are eight nucleus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are eight nucleated cell. Now how it is seven celled structure? This is one cell, this is second cell, this is third cell, this is fourth cell, this is fifth cell, and this is six cell, and this complete structure is seventh cell. Okay, cytokinesis will not take place in polar nuclei. Cytokinesis will not take place in polar nuclei. Due to cytokinesis, these nucleus will get wall around themselves. Okay, so this is eight nucleated and seven cell structure. Got it? Okay.